ओम ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मे ते
ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मे ते
मूर्ति भेद विभागिने
मूर्ति भेद विभागिने
व्योम वद्व्याप्त देहाय
व्योमव्याप्तदेहाय
दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः
दक्षिणामूर्तये
नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भाम्
सदाशिवसमारम्भाम्
शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम्
शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम्
अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम्
अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम्
वन्दे गुरु परम्पराम्
वन्दे गुरु परम्पराम्
ॐ सहनाववतु
सहनाववतु
सहनौ भुनक्तु
सहनौ भुनक्तु
सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै
तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै
ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
ॐ
शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम्
ॐ
पार्थाय
प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम्
व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्
व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्
अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम्
अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं
भगवतीं अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवत्वेषिणीम् यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतस्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः
यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतस्तुन्वन्ति
वेदै साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैर्गायन्ति यं सामगाः
वेदै साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैर्गायन्ति यं सामगाः
ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः
ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः
यस्यां तन्न विदुःसुरासुरगणादेवाय तस्मै नमः सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वेशे सर्वशक्ति समन्विते वयेभ्यस्त्राहिनो देवी दुर्गे देवी नमोस्तु ते रोगानशेषानपहंसि तुष्टारुष्टा तु कामान् सकलानभीष्टान् त्वामाश्रितानान्न विपन्नराणां त्वामाश्रिता ह्य श्रयतां प्रयान्ति सर्वा बाधा प्रशमनं त्रैलोक्यस्याखिलेश्वरी एवमेव त्वया कार्यम् अस्मद्वैरिविनाशनम् सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वेशे सर्वशक्ति समन्विते वयेभ्यस्त्राहिनो देवी दुर्गे देवी नमोस्तु ते रोगानशेषानपहंसि तुष्टारुष्टा तु कामान् सकला नभीष्टान् त्वामाश्रितानान्न विपन्नराणां त्वामाश्रिता ह्यश्रयतां प्रयान्ति सर्वा बाधा प्रशमनं त्रैलोक्यस्याखिलेश्वरी एवमेव त्वया कार्यम् अस्मद्वैरिविनाशनम् From today, we are going to start 7th chapter. And the name of 7th chapter is Jnana Vijnana Yoga. Before starting 7th chapter, we can look into first summary of first 6th chapter. That what I have told you yesterday. It says, Bhagavad Gita is consist of 18th chapters, total 18 chapters. Each chapter, they say, we can put in six chapters. It's called Shataka. Shataka means a group of six chapters. It's called Shataka. So first six, middle six, and last six. So first six is called Prathama Shataka. Middle one is called Madhyama Shataka. And last one is called Charam Shataka, ultimate. In Prathama Shataka, we have completed 1 to 6, total 6 chapter. Now we will enter in Madhyama Shataka. It is 7 to 12 chapters. And last, we will say 13 to 18 chapters. It's called Charama Shataka. In every Shataka, it says there are 3 topics. Predominantly 3 topics. Small, there are many topics, but predominantly 3 topics. In first Prathama Shataka, what we have seen, 3 topics are, first one is called Jiva Swarupam. Jiva means oneself. Swarupam, the nature. Jivasya Swarupam, iti Jiva Swarupam. The nature of Jiva, we have seen in 1 to 6 chapter. Then Bhagavan has talked about sadhana. It's also discussed in 1 to 6 chapter. And last one we have seen is 3 main topic is Atma Krupa. Atma Krupa means there are 4 Krupas we have seen. Ishvara Krupa, Guru Krupa, Shastra Krupa. The grace of Ishvara, the grace of teacher, the grace of scriptures. And fourth one grace is Atma Krupa. We grace one own self. It's called Atma Krupa. Or we can say we put effort to know oneself. It's Atma Krupa. 1 to 6 chapter, generally, Bhagavan talked about Jiva. So according to Chandogya Upanishad, this Mahavakya, we always say Tat Tvamasi. Is called Mahavakya. Tat means that. Ishvara. Tvam means Jiva. And Asi means both are identical. It's like E is equal to MC square. According to Pujya Swami, it is the equation. Ishvara is equal to Jiva. Is called Mahavakya. So Tvam Pada in Chandogya is denoted as a Jiva. So first 6 chapters are called Tvam Pada Pradhanah. Pada means word. Tvam means a word. Tvam Pad. In Tattvamasi, middle one is called Tvam, means Jiva. Predominantly, 1 to 6 chapters, Bhagavan has discussed Jiva means Tvam, word. In Madhyama Shataka, Bhagavan will discuss Ishvarasya Swarupam, the nature of Ishvara, the truth of Ishvara. Here also, Bhagavan will discuss sadhana, which sadhana. And last, Bhagavan will say, even Ishvaraha Anugraha. Here I have written wrongly. Here it will call Tat Prad, Tatapad. Because Ishvara is always third person for us. So this Madhyama Shataka is Tat Pada Pradhanah. Predominantly, Bhagavan has discussed Ishvara in this. So Tat Pada Pradhanah. And last 13 to 18th chapters are called Charama Shataka. We have Nirvan Shataka, you know. Shataka means 6. Here also 3 topics. main topic in last shataka is aikyam. Aikyam between tat and tvam, between jiva and ishvara, is aikyam asipada, is discussed in last charama. Kshetragnam chapi mam viddhi sarva kshetreshu bharata. That verse is in 13th chapter, is called Mahavakya of Bhagavad Gita. Because Bhagavan is Kshetragnam chapi mam viddhi. Kshetragnam, one who knows Kshetra. So one who is a living consciousness is called Kshetragna. Mam viddhi, you should know me. Kshetragnam, should you know I am Kshetragna. And where? Sarva Kshetreshu Bharata. I am available in all Kshetras, means in all bodies. This Bhagavan says, whatever sitting inside the body and me, both are one. So this is Mahavakya. Predominantly discussed in this Charama Shataka is generally Triguna. Trigunya Vishaya, all three Guna, Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, is beautifully discussed in this Charama Shataka. And in 15th chapter, Bhagavan has discusses Atma Jnana. So what we have seen in Prathama Shataka, today we will see quickly, but we have to see. Prathama Jiva Swarupa. So I have written here, in Prathama Shataka, there are three topics. First topic is Jiva Swarupa, the nature of individual. And in this whole, we have seen, Bhagavan has taught us through Arjuna that any individual is not body, mind, sense complex. We all are individual, vyakti, vyashti. We are not mere body, mind, sense complex. Bhagavan has taught us. And Bhagavan says, our essential nature is not body, mind, but our essential nature is consciousness only. Chaitanyata is our original nature, our swarupa, the truth of us. And we have seen, what is this body Bhagavan has given us? So body is like a container, and consciousness is contained in this container. And we are consciousness, we are not body. We are contained in this body. Otherwise, I can also say this body-mind-sense complex is an instrument. And we are using this instrument. We are not instrument. We never proclaim or we never announce that my car is my instrument for transportation, but we never announce I am the car. Spoon is the instrument for eating. We never announce that I am spoon. Same way, this both instruments are given to us. Gross body and subtle body, both are instrument, but we are not instrument. This is given in first sataka. And I have also written, within this body, mind, sense, complex cabinet, Satchidatma is though available. Actually, it is everywhere. But here, it is just we can feel it. That's why, as though Satchidatma is available in this body, mind, sense, complex cabinet. So our real nature is nothing but Satchidatma. That's why we say Satchidananda. That becomes the Satchidananda Atma. This is our real nature. And where Bhagavan has discussed our real nature. So I have given some example from second to up to sixth chapter. Bhagavan has discussed our real nature. Really speaking, in second chapter, from 12 verse to 25 verse, Bhagavan has discussed our real nature. Nityaha, Bhagavan has discussed In second chapter is what was there? Natve vaham jatunasam natvam neme janadipaha nacheva bhavishyamaha sarve vaya atav param. The meaning of param, Bhagavan has given Shankaracharya as a nitya. Na jayate na mriyate va na kadachit nayam putva bhavita na bhuyaha ajo nityam. This is nirvikari. Our real nature is we doesn't have any modification. So we are nirvikari. Vikari means modification. Nirgataha vikaram yasya sa nirvikari. So we don't have any type of changes. Sarva vyapi. Maya tatamidam. Tatam Bhagavan has discussed. Avinashi tadviddi. Yena sarvam idam tatam. The meaning of tatam means all pervasive. Our real nature is not, we are just up to body, mind, sense complex, but we are all pervasive. It's called sarvavyapi. Our real nature is we are not doer, even we are not enjoyer. And Bhagavan has discussed is ya enam vetti hantaram yachainam manyate hatam ubhautau na vijanita nayam hanti na hanyate. So our real nature is we are non-doer, we are not enjoyer also. Aprameyah, our real nature is we cannot be measured, we cannot have knowledge with the help of five sense organ. It's called aprameyah. This is our real nature. Bhagavan has discussed in second chapter. In third chapter, last portion, Bhagavan has discussed our nature. Indriyani paranyahu indriyebhyascha param manaha manasastu para buddhihi yo buddhe paratastu saha. The meaning of para is more subtle, more pervasive. It's called parani. So who is more subtle? Indriya, our sense organs are more subtle than vishayaha, sense object. Indriyebhyah param manaha. Mind is more subtle than sense organ. Manasastu parabuddhihi. Our intellect is more subtle than mind. Buddhehe paratastu saha. Even for from intellect. Saha is in last one, indriyani. And who is saha? So that Ishvara. Buddhehe paratastu saha. And we are that. Is discussed in last verses of third chapter. So in third chapter also Bhagavan has discussed. In fourth chapter is like a granthi shloka is given in fourth chapter. Karmani akarma yah pashyet akarmani cha karma yah sabuddhimana manushyeshu sayukta krishna karma krut yah pashyet. One who can see karmani akarma, a person who can see I am actionlessness in action, and one who can see akarmani cha karma yah, one who can see action in actionlessness. So in short, Bhagavan would like to tell us our body and mind are always keep on doing karma. They never stop because anatma keep on working. So they are always karmani. They keep on karmani. But our real nature as a consciousness, it is Sachidananda. Our real nature is akarma. Because being all pervasive, sarvavyapi, we cannot do any karma. We need not to do any karma. So in spite of this body, mind, sense complex, we can see in body, mind, sense complex, I am akarta bhokta. This is called yaha akarmani akarma pashye. At the same time, akarmani cha karma yaha. As though it look our body doesn't work when we go to sleep, but still inside all keep on working. This all anatma, our all physiological system, in our all cells keep on changing. So karma, yah pashyet, one who can see the action where akarmani anatma, as the anatma is not working, but still they are working only. Even nowadays, all physicists say the pillar is look steady, but inside pillar there are many atoms. They keep on moving. So akarmani, pillar is akarma, but still karma. They keep on doing work. So one who can understand this, sa person manusheshu buddhimana, that person considered as a wise person, viveki atmagnani. And that person, Krishna karma krut, that person has done everything, need not to do any karma, because that person see oneself everywhere. And even there is a vision of atmagyani in fourth chapter, brahmarpanam brahmavi brahmagno brahmanahutam. What is our real nature? So real nature is everything here is nothing but Brahma. And as a person myself, I am not away from Brahman. I am Brahman. So everything is here is nothing but Brahma eva. And I am not separate from Brahma is also Jnanam, is discussed in fourth chapter. In fifth chapter, what we have seen, Bhagavan says, Sarva karmani manasa sanyasya aste sukham vashi navadvare pure dehi neva kurvan nakarayan. Dehi means consciousness. Manasa, while sitting inside the body, that dehi, what that dehi means, one who is atmagnana, what they thinks, sarva karmani sanyasya. That person renunciate all karmas, but how? Manasa eva, through mind that person is given, and still aste, it is sitting inside the body, sukham, easily, happily, and inside, in spite of living inside the body, na kurvan na karayan, he doesn't do anything and he doesn't ask anyone to do anything. Na kurvan na karayan. Navadvare pure, our body has 9 doors that we have seen. So in fifth chapter also, Bhagavan has discussed the real nature of oneself. In last sixth chapter, here Bhagavan has not discussed, but Bhagavan says, what is the vision of Atmagyani? So that person, sarva bhutastham atmanam sarva bhutani cha atmani ikshate. That person atmanam sarva bhutastham ikshate. That person sees oneself in all beings, and all beings sarva bhutani in oneself. That person is called the vision of oneness, sarvatra samadarshana yoga yuktatma, is endowed with that vision. So all is discussed in all chapters. So these are the main topics of first two Prathama Shataka. Second topic, what we have seen Prathama Shataka, is sadhana. Which sadhana Bhagavan has emphasized in first Prathama Shataka? So that one is Karma Yoga Sadhana. The main sadhana is being discussed. And second chapter, I have written only a little bit. The main is karmani eva adhikara hate ma phale shupadachana. We have choice only with reference to karma only. Karmani vishaye, our choice is there, but we don't have any choice with reference to result of actions. And that we have seen in discuss detail. And we have also seen yoga karma sukaushalam samatvam yoga uchyate. both definition of karma yoga is also given in second chapter also. So karma yoga is just Bhagwan has started in second chapter, but in detail Bhagwan has discussed in third chapter. Even the name of third chapter is nothing but karma yoga only. So total chapter is dedicated to whom? Karma yoga. But main karma yoga Bhagwan has discussed is Pancha Mahayagna for all householders. So we have seen in karma yoga Deva Yagna. First will Deva Yagna, then Pitru Yagna, then Brahma Yagna, Deva Yagna, Pitru Yagna. Brahma Yagya, Manushya Yagya and Bhuta Yagya. All our responsibility we have to perform like Ishwararpan Buddhi, and we have to accept all results of karma like a Prasad Buddhi. That is discussed in detail in third chapter. So mainly Panch Mahayagna, even the main, which one, third one is, main one is, Yagnarthat karmano nyatra lokoyam karma bandhana. Yagnarthat mean Ishwarathat. That is in ninth verse of third chapter. So whatever we do is the offer of Ishwara, and what we have received is a prasada. That is discussed in third chapter. This is the main sadhana. According to my thinking, so what is the best sadhana in our life is karma yoga only. In fourth chapter, Bhagwan has not discussed any karma yoga. So I didn't write here. But in fifth chapter, again, Bhagwan has discussed in this 10th verse, Brahmani adhaya karmani sangan tyaktva karoti yaha lipyate nasapapena padmapatram iva ambasa. Yaha karoti, again, a person who performs action, but in which way? Yaha karmani karoti, a person who performs karma, but brahmani adhaya, having offered to Ishwara. Here brahmani means Ishwara. Sangam tyaktva, having given up the attachment with reference to result of karma, that person, papena na lipyate, that person is never attached with result of any action. Papena, even punyena pina lipyate. And like what? Padma patra iva ambasa. Like a leaf of lotus, never touch, even in spite leaves inside the water, but water cannot touch the leaf of lotus. Same way, we keep on performing karma, but if our attitude is, I'm just doing karma for the sake of Ishwara, not for me, then we are like a Padma Patramiva Mambasa. Same way, I am receiving all result of action, but like what? Prasada Buddhi. So still our mind is Padma Patra Ivambasa. Here the Padma Patra Ivambasa, the meaning is Samatvam Yoga Uchyate. Our mind is balanced with reference to karma also. Our mind is balanced with reference to accepting the result of karma also. It's called Padma. Water never touched the leaf. Same way, any result cannot touch us. And while performing karma, we don't have any raga dvesha. Without raga dvesha, Padma Patra Iva. So it is discussed. There are many, but this is the main. Padmapatra. In sixth chapter, Bhagwan has discussed first shloka only, Anashritaha Karma Phalam Karya Karmam Karoti Yaha Sasanyasi Cha Yogi Cha Naniragnihi Nacha Akriyaha. Anashritaha san Yaha Karyam Karma Karoti. Here also Bhagwan has emphasized a person who performs to be done action. Karyam means to be done. Karaniya, Karyam and Kartavyam, both have same meaning. In Sanskritam, there are three words. Kartavya is well known for us. Kartavya means to be done. Kartavya karma. Kartavya, then Karyam. Last one is Karaniyam. All have same meaning, means to be done. So here Bhagwan says Karyam Karma means to be done Karya. So Panchamahayagna, whatever our responsibility, yah Karyam Karma Karoti, but Karma phalam anashritaha, without expecting the result of action. Is karma phalam, that person is really sannyasi, yogi cha, he is a karma yogi, not like a sannyasi, one who has given up all karma because they don't like to keep any responsibility with them. So better niragnihi means sannyasi, literal sannyasi, compared to that sannyasi, this karma yogi is better. So Bhagwan is also praises this karma yogi. So in short, the sadhana Bhagwan has discussed in first to sixth chapter is nothing but karma yoga. So karma yoga means proper action and proper attitude. I always say karma has two meanings in karma yoga. One, the meaning of karma means how to perform karma. And another meaning of karma means how to receive the karma phala. And yoga means attitude. Ishwararpana buddhi is called yoga. Prasada buddhi is also called yoga. So proper action and proper attitude is equal to karma yoga. That is discussed in detail in first six chapters. And last one, Bhagwan has discussed is, third topic is self-effort. Tapping our free will. What I have said, there are four krupa. Ishwara krupa. One is called Ishwara krupa. One is called Shastra Krupa, and last third one is called Guru Krupa. The grace, all three are always showering grace on us. Ishwar never say no to shower his grace. So Ishwara grace is all over the universe. Even Shastra is open to all. Anybody can understand Shastra. Guru is also available. Shishya, if really speaking student is sincere, Guru is always there to teach them. But all grace are available when we can know, when we have Atma Krupa, when we put effort to know whether Ishvara is there or not, then we can understand, is always available. Even we try to understand what Shastra says. The last one is more important, is everything is there, but we have to put effort. And to put effort, we have to use our free will. That has been discussed in fourth chapter, I think, sixth chapter. Mostly people used to say, law of karma says we are the result of past. You know, there are many fatalistic. They say we can't do anything because we are experiencing our own karma. need not to do. But right now, what we are is a result of our karma, but we can change our future by selecting proper action with proper attitude. So this is Bhagavan is asked to do. In sixth chapter, fifth verse, Uddhare dātmanātmānam nātmānam avasādayet. Atma eva hi atmanah banduhu, atma eva ripu atmanah. Atmana atmanam uddharet. We can pull ourselves with the help of oneself. Na atmanam avasādayet. We should not reject our oneself because we are friend of ourselves. And if we are not proper attitude, then we are the enemy of ourselves. So whole focus is we only. What we think that we can do. That's why the role of free will is mentioned in second chapter. Bhagavan has said, karmani eva adhikarahate. Adhikar means choice. We can use our free will and we can select our karma. That Bhagavan has emphasized in first to six. And I have written here how we can make our destiny. It says what we think, so we speak. This is very common. There is one sentence is what we think, so we speak. What we speak, we perform the actions. Our actions become habit, and habit creates character. And that character makes our destiny. So everything depends on us only. So having discussed in detail, now we are entering in Madhyama Shataka. In Madhyama Shataka, we have seen, again Bhagavan will discuss in three main topic. And what are these three main topic? So I have written here. In previous Prathama Shataka, Jiva Swarupa was there. But in Madhyama Shataka, we will see what is the real nature of Ishvara. That will be discussed. And here Bhagavan will discuss three things. Nature of Ishvara. Function of Ishvara. Bhagavan, Bhagavataha Karya. What Bhagavan is doing for us. And glories of Ishvara. In 10th chapter, glories. In, I think, 7, even 9, Ishvara Swarupa. In function, Kalosmi Pravruttaha. Bhagavan discussed his function only. In Prathama Shataka, we have seen our body is container. And this consciousness is contained in this body. But here in this Madhyama Shataka, universe is a container of Ishvara. And Ishvara himself as a Chaitanya contained in the whole container of universe. That it will discuss in Madhyama Shataka. In Prathama Shataka, we have seen discussion of sadhana is karma yoga sadhana. Jiva has to do karma yoga sadhana. So in karma yoga sadhana, so here predominantly we are using our gross body. Karma yoga, we are using our gross body. But in Madhyama Shataka, what would be the sadhana? So here it will come Ishvarasya dhanam. Ishvara Dhyanam, and Upasana is mentioned. All type of Upasana. So in previous, body was main thing. In Upasana means meditation. Here, Manopradana. Here, mind is given more importance. So this is one type of journey. Which type of journey? gross to subtle form. Karma yoga is a gross because we are using our gross body. While in Madhyama Shataka is meditation. Meditation, we are using our sukshma mind, subtle mind. So it's difference between Prathama Shataka and Madhyama Shataka. In Prathama Shataka, we have seen self-effort is emphasized. Uddharedatmanatmanam. But only self-effort doesn't work. We need Ishwarasya Anugraha. So in Madhyama Shataka, what is the discussion? So Bhagavan is Ishwarasya Anugraha. That's why everywhere, in maximum, if you check now, Bhagavan has used Mama Shabda, means Asmad Pratyaya, whole Aham Avam Vayam, is used maximum from 7th to 12th chapter. And here even Bhagavan says it's 9th chapter. Man Mana Bhava Mad Bhaktaha Madhya Jimam Namaskuru Mam Eva Aishyasi Yukta Evam Atmanam Matparai. Everywhere Bhagavan is, you become, you give your mind to me, you become devotee to me, you please keep on namaskara to me. If you do like this, Mam Eva Aishyasi, you will get me. You will prop Aishyasi means it is a future tense. You will get me and Matparayana. So everywhere, maximum Bhagavan has used Asmad Pratyaya. Mom. And that asmad means aham pratyaya is revealed by Bhagavan in two ways again. Aham means I. Bhagavan has revealed oneself aham as a Ishvara also, and aham as a Nirguna Brahman also. And without knowing Ishvara, we cannot able to understand Brahman. So both Bhagavan has discussed in Shataka. Brahman is less, but still Bhagavan has discussed. So more we know Ishvara, more we understand Brahman. That's why Bhagavan has always said, you please surrender to me. And then Bhagavan says, yoga kshemam vahamyam. There are many vows are taken by Ishvara. In this shataka, beautifully, in 9th, Name Bhakta Pranashyasi is taken vow pratigna by Ishvara. Yoga Kshemam Vahamiham is another pratigya or vow is taken. All beautiful content is Bhagavan has mentioned in this. So this is the beautiful, the middle portion of Bhagavad Gita is totally devoted to Ishvara only. First portion is totally devoted to Jiva only, and last portion is a Aikya. And to become one with Ishvara, which type of lifestyle we need, which type of guna, means sattva, rajo, guna, which type we need, everything is being discussed in last portion. Generally, we see last portion is nothing. If 14th is also nothing, all guna. Even 17th chapter is nothing. What is Dhanam? How to live a lifestyle is discussed. Main, Ishvara and Jiva is discussed only in first two shataka. Having understanding this, now we will enter in 7th chapter. Even the name of 7th chapter, is Jnana Vijnana Yoga. Generally, Jnana and Vijnana both are one and same, knowledge only. But when Bhagavan has used, or Madhusudan Saraswati has used both names together, so what is the meaning of Jnanam? See, I can say the meaning of Jnanam is knowledge only. But which type of knowledge? Right now, what we all have. We all know what is given in Shastra. So I am not separate from Ishvara. Everything is here is Ishvara. Being Upadan Karan, Ishvara is himself is manifesting in the form of word. Everything we know, this is called jnana. But vijnana means when we assimilate this jnana, we can be one with this jnana. It's called vijnana, visheshena jnana. Now that jnanam becomes myself. Here, this jnanam at a buddhi level and mind is work according to its own way. But vijnana means mind and buddhi becomes one and same. What buddhi says, mind accept. And what mind says, buddhi accept. Mind never say no, what is buddhi says. If buddhi says, I am not separate from Ishvara, then mind says, I know, I am Ishvara. This is called vijnana. Here, jnana means at intellect level, we know everything. But still, mind is not, like Pujya Swamiji says, mind has its own tantrum. And he never ready to accept what is the jnana given in Upanishad. But when both become one and same, then it's become a vijnana. Visheshena jnana. That everything Bhagavan will discuss in this chapter. Jnana and vijnana. I think we will start seventh chapter next time because we have already discussed this. Even to describe this, it will take a long time. So we will start with Bhashya. I cannot explain Bhashya long. That's why next time we will see. But any question regarding this from Madhyama Shataka and Prathama Shataka, beautiful is given. I have written from somewhere only, but beautifully good.
Very beautiful summary, Swamiji. Very nice, putting it all together. And this jnana vijnana is very definition. Mind and buddhi becoming one. Mind says, whatever buddhi says, mind accepts.
Right now, our mind is not ready to accept. We all know, no? Everything here is Ishvara, but still, we ever, always our vyavara with word is different. Not like jnani. But when we become jnani, it's called vijnani.
A non-protesting mind. Mind whom we can tell what to do rather than mind dictating to us. That's great, isn't it?
In my thinking, is a mind, you know, is a simple mind who is ready to accept everything, the people as they are, without judgmenting, without doing judge, one who can accept is called simple mind. In such mind, jnana will stay. Otherwise, mind is always side. Why this is? Why this is? But if mind is ready to accept everyone, then not. Then vijnanam will take place. It's called vijnanam. Anything else?
Swaminiji, in the sixth chapter, right? So you talk about sadhanas, karma yoga.
Mm-hmm.
But in sixth chapter, dhyana sadhana is highlighted.
Highlighted, yeah.
Right? You know, talking about the mind that, you know, Hemlataji was mentioning. Yeah. So how to bring mind under your guidance rather than you being under mind's guidance, you know, so you... Because I don't like the word control, because somehow control involves some sort of violence.
That's why Bhagavan has explained in sixth chapter, shanehi shanehi uparamet. Slowly our mind will understand. But to make mind understand, I think Ishvara's grace is very much necessary. Because we don't know why mind keep on asking, why mind is complaining. Sometimes even we don't know. So if we surrender to Ishvara, then the mind will be taken care of by Ishvara. And slowly, mind will accept to everyone. This is necessary. Mind should open. Mind should accept people as they are. Even they are good or not, it's not our problem. all are fine. Yeah. This, if mind can accept, no, this we have to do, to not control, but we have to make them understand our mind. Okay, you try to understand. It's not kshama, it's like a kshama, no, accommodate all people as they are. More we can do like this, then more we can accept. That's why all values are very much necessary.
Yeah.
13th chapter.
So, Swaminiji, in fact, this is what is happening to us now, is actually the mind is controlling us. So actually the mind is doing violence.
Yeah. But we don't want to retaliate, you know. If you retaliate, it gets very bad.
The mind is violent and it is actually taking us away from everything where we are supposed to be.
Yeah.
You know, so it's actually atyachar, what is happening.
Emotionally, you know, they always blackmailing. Mind is always emotionally blackmail.
Yes. Just doesn't keep quiet. Something or the other. Oh, no, this, that.
Because that's why we don't know why mind is doing like this. Because unconscious, no?
Unconscious.
It's always, this mind is controlled by unconscious. And we don't know what is in unconscious. So who can take care of unconscious? Only Ishwar. To unload unconscious is not in our hand.
Mm-hmm.
So always we offer Ishwara, no? Then it will be taken.
Because if we can actually, Swaminiji, I tried this thought experiment, right? So suppose, you know, I've lived 50 plus years, right? And, you know, 50 times 365 times how many ever minutes or seconds that I've been alive, every second I have been thinking something or the other, you know, throughout my life. And hence all of these thought patterns have piled up, you know, inside my brain or whatever you want to call it, you know. So now suddenly I try to figure out, why am I thinking like this? I don't know. Maybe I have cultivated these thoughts sometime in my past, you know, some values that I have bought into and some social structures that people say these are the right things, these are the things you should go after. So I have bought into all of these things, and so I have been inculcating these thoughts over a long period of time. So it is already there, right? I cannot understand when and where I put it in. And
this we don't know from where it comes.
And if you accept our shastras, Purva Janmas and things like that, then it gets infinite. I mean, I just can't even understand.
So then the one way is also to replace one vritti with another, because the vrittis won't go away. So that is why you keep giving new vrittis, shastra vrittis.
Yeah.
And like japa and all that. So Ishwara related vrittis, so that, you know, the more you give this, maybe that will subside.
Like that patra, no, vessel. This vessel is full of water. But if we keep on pouring milk, then one day will come, this whole water will go out. It will be filled with milk. Same with, that's why Nididhyasana. Even Shravanam is like that. We are filling up new thought process in our mind.
So you have a big vessel and you keep adding little drops of milk. It's going to take a long time.
You know, in Mandukya Upanishad,
it's going to be full.
In Mandukya Upanishad, there is one comparison has come. Gaudapadacharya ji has done. Like you would like to take out your kashaya. It's like what? You are taking a drop of water from ocean. How it will take time long. Mm. It cannot be possible. Same way, we cannot remove our kashaya. It's like that. So we don't know how past sanskara is there. So this is the waste process, you know. Give everything you offer.
Yeah.
You take care.
Offer to Ishwar.
Offer to Ishwar.
Ishwar arpana buddhi. So Swaminiji, we are doing chapter 11 or 12. 12, no?
Bhakti yoga.
Class, yeah.
Yeah.
The sadhana, it's like first you offer everything to Ishwara.
Mm.
karma you do as offering to Ishwar. But then if you can't do that, then you offer the result to Ishwara. Karma phala to Ishwara. That is easier to do.
Yeah.
So the karma phala is offered. But that what it really means is that when you offer the karma phala, it also means that you're offering the karma to Ishwara eventually.
Yeah.
That's what it means.
Yeah.
But you start with this sadhana. And Krishna says this, in fact, this is better. Whatever comes, you accept as prasada.
Tyaga shanti anantaram.
That is of. Yes. So even if we can't offer all our karmas and we keep doing karma for our own sake, at least we say, okay, whatever phala we get, we offer it. We accept it as prasada.
Even for artharth, you know, it says that you can strive for any worldly thing, but whatever you achieve, you know, first offer to Ishwar. Then you can begin.
Yes.
No problem.
Then it becomes prasada.
Prasada. More attitude is Bhagavan likes attitude only.
If we can unload the eye sense, then attitude will automatically come. You keep saying, I am doing it. This is the problem, right? You never say, Ishwara is the one responsible for whatever we do. That doesn't come in your mind. You say, I.
Oh, like Bhartohari.
You can drop that.
Like that Bhartohari, you know. I have given up everything.
Yes, I have given up. What is that? Tena something teja, tat teja.
Tena teja ti tat teja. Yena teja ti tat teja.
Tena teja ti tat
teja. Yeah, give up that by which you have given up, right?
Yes.
Shall we do now? Who are mother?
Anything? See, Swamiji, now we have been, we know it. We know the sadhana also, what to do, but we are still not doing. So this is the problem.
Yeah, abhyasa and vairagya.
That's also, we know what is to be done. Also, Krishna has told you, right? This you do this, if you can't do this, you do this, but we are not doing anything.
Well, we know from our experience, right? You tell your children all the time, do they do it? No.
Same way, mind is like child only.
Yeah, exactly.
You said something, Swamiji, chittayet balakam or something. You said palayet chittam or something. You know, in Sanskrit, you say those things. There is a word for this. Beautiful sayings, like short sayings, you know, like proverbs kind of a thing.
Right now, it doesn't come in my mind.
So it's like says mind is like a child, you know. So you have to be nice and gentle and caring. Sometimes you have to be hard and harsh. So like that balayet something, it comes. I will see what Swamiji says. Swami TV says this.
Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate.
Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om.
See you next week.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Thank you, Swamiji.